Hi, hello, welcome to Homeschool. This is your class 8 mathematics NCERT or CBSE board. Today we are going to start a new chapter, linear equations in one variable. This chapter is a continuation of your previous class, class 7 simple equations. Just it is the extension of that chapter. I hope you are all perfect with that chapter. If you feel you have missed any of the basic of this chapter, you can go to class 7 simple equations and just watch 2 or 3 parts, or you can see mathematics basics. In that, basics of algebra, you can go, these all tiny basics covered in that. Before knowing about an equation, we just go through variables, constant, term, what is the expression, what is an equation, then comes to linear equation in one variable. Okay. What are variables? Variables are the symbols used in algebra. Variables are the symbols used in algebra. And these symbols, the value of these symbols are not fixed. Example, variables are the symbols used in algebra, and the value of these symbols are not fixed. Then what type of a symbols we are going to take? The symbols are alphabets. We use to represent variables with the alphabets, like X, Y, A, B, P, Q, any alphabet you can take to represent any variable. And observe here, always in every problem X is X only? No. X will be having a numerical value. Means X value is changing for every time. It is going to vary every time. So we call this as a variable. Why we call these symbols as variables? The value of these symbols is not fixed. It will be changing always. Right? Suppose sometimes x value may be 5 and sometimes x value may be 2 or minus 1 or any value it may be. The value of these variables is not fixed. Constant. It is also a symbol with fixed numerical value. Constant is also a symbol. It is used to represent the fixed numerical value. Example, I may take it as 2, 5, minus 3, 7 by 2 or any number, the number is fixed. Constant is a symbol with a fixed numerical value. Okay. So any number, the number would be varied. Right? Here the value will be varied always. And this number is fixed. It is constant. Next, coming to the word term. What is term? Term, it is a combination of a constant or a variable or both. So what do you mean by this a constant? I say 3 is a term, 5 is a term, only number also I can say it as a term. And next, variable x is also a term. Here both means it is a product of a number and variable. That is 5y. Number and variable are multiplied. That means 5 is a numerical coefficient of y and y is an algebraic coefficient of 5y. Right? 3. It is a term with only number. Fixed number. And here you have only one variable. That is also a term. And here 5y. It is a product of a number with variable. This is also a term. Suppose if I write 5PQ. 5PQ is also a single term, whereas here you have two variables with the number multiplied. This is numerical coefficient of these, right? 5PQ, these are all single terms. Then coming to expression, what is an expression? Expression, it is a collection of one or more terms which are separated with a plus or minus sign. Suppose, let me write an example for expression here. X plus 3. How many terms you can see? There are two terms. In that, one is variable and one is constant. How many terms? Two terms. Suppose, if I write x minus 5 and a plus 3, p, 2p minus 5. Observe here, these are all expressions. These are all expression. It is a collection of one or more terms. Here having only one variable. Suppose if I write x plus y minus 3. Is it an expression? Yes. Of how many terms? Three terms. 1, 2, 3. And I say that in this expression you have two variables. What are the variables? X and y. And this 3 is a constant. Expression, it is a collection of terms which are separated with plus or minus sign. Then when does this expression becomes equation? When two expressions are separated with the equality sign. When two expressions, suppose let me take x plus 3 is equal to 5. What is this? Equality. What is the symbol? Equality. If I put here equal symbol, then it becomes a equation. Expression only terms will be there. Here, along with the combination of terms with equality, if you have, we call it as a equation. And observe here, equality sign, this side, left hand side, and that side, right hand side. So this is left hand side, x plus 3 left hand side, and only 5 is right hand side. This is equation and these are expressions. And when does expression becomes equation? When any expression is written with the equality sign, then we say it as a equation. Suppose I may write this one, 2p minus 5 equal to 0. Equality if I use, it becomes a equation. This is left hand side and this is right hand side. Okay, are you able to get it? LHS, RHS. Solving of these equations we have done in class 7. One complete chapter we have done. And this solving you can do in two methods. One is balancing the equation and another is transposing. Let me show you both here. First, let me show by taking this example, x plus 3 is equal to 5. By balancing, how do we solve this equation by balancing method? Try to remember. Plus 3 you have. So what we need to do? Subtract 3 on both sides. Left hand side and right hand side. Plus 3 minus 3 cancel. Or 3 minus 3 will be 0. X is equal to 5 minus 3 will be 2. What is this method? Balancing method. Or another method I will show for you. That is transposing method to solve any equation. Transposing method, same question. X plus 3 is equal to 5. Other than the variable, what you can see number? That number transpose other side. When you are transposing other side of equality, the sign will be changed. X is equal to 5 plus 3 there here. When you transpose, it becomes minus 3. X is equal to 5 minus 3 is 2. Observe here, here same answer and here also same answer. Like this, you may do either this method or this method. Similarly, if you have any two multiple here, observe here, 2x is equal to 2 there. Still, for x you have one more number, numerical coefficient there. I don't want this also. So what we need to do? Dividing 2 on both sides. Dividing 2 on both sides. 2 cancel, 2 1 is your answer. Suppose in transposing method, how to do that? 2x is equal to 2 there. See, this 2 is a multiple for this variable. Multiple, if it is transposed other side, it will be divided. X is equal to 2 by 2. X is equal to 1. Okay, don't be confused. Either any of the method you can choose. Suppose if any question asks for you only balancing method, you go in that method. Otherwise, you can use directly this transposing method. See, we got here x value is 1 and here also you got x value 1. When we say it as an equation, when that value satisfies LHS and RHS condition. Suppose let me take again 2x plus 3 is equal to 5. Okay, now substitute x value in this. 2 into 1 plus 3 is equal to 5. Wherever you have x, substitute this value, what you got, right? 2 into 1 is 2, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, 2 plus 3 is 5, 5 equal to 5. That means LHS is equal to RHS. Then only we see that it is satisfying the equation, okay? See, whenever we write with the equality sign, this should be equal to this. Suppose if we solve this x plus 3 equal to 5, what we got x value? X value is 2, right? This 2 substitute here, 2 plus 3, 5. 5 equal to 5. It satisfies. Suppose if you get here any 7 equal to 5 or anything you get, then it is not satisfying. Now coming to linear equation. What is a linear equation? What we have done, these are all linear equations only. If you want, you can see here 2p minus 5 equal to 0. It is a linear equation. How you can say? In this equation, you can see equality and one variable is present. And can you observe the variable here? P. Observe this. This is the variable. And its variable power must be 1. What is power here? Can you see anything here? Nothing. Nothing means 1. Okay. This power, if it is 1 or highest power of the variable, we call it as a degree. If degree is 1, we say that equation as a linear equation. Observe here. 5x minus 6 equal to 0. 5x minus 3 equal to 7, right? These are all linear equations where having equality and the variable power is 1. Okay, or I may write another example. Suppose if you take this example, 2y minus 5 is equal to y plus 3. So what happens? Both sides you have same variable. They are separated with the equality. Then I say this as a linear equation. How many variables you can see? Only one. Then you can say this is a linear equation. Then what is linear equation? One variable. Linear equation in one variable. Only one variable will be there. Suppose if I take x plus 3 is equal to y minus 2. Do I call this as a linear equation? Yes, it is a linear equation, but having two variables, x and y, two variables are present here. But for our chapter, we are dealing only with linear equations with one variable. Okay, I may not consider this. Suppose if you have x square minus 7 equal to 0. It is also an equation. But is it a linear equation? No. Why we say no here? Observe, the power of the variable is 2. If it is 1 or nothing there means it is 1. If it is 2, we cannot say this as a linear equation. Then what type of an equation? Quadratic equation. These type of equations we may solve in future. Okay. So we are going to study only linear equations in one variable. And this is also two variable. We don't study now. So let's have a recap of what all we have discussed now. Variable. These are the symbols used in algebra. Variables, we use alphabets to represent these variables and the value of these variables are not fixed. Okay, then constant, a symbol with fixed numerical value and those value is fixed. It doesn't change. It is always same. Term, it is either a constant, a variable or both. See here, constant, variable, see. This is not a constant but numerical coefficient with variable. Phi y I can say here. Phi pq, this is also a term but with two variables it is. Now next coming to expression. Expression, it is a collection of terms and are separated with a plus or minus sign is called expression. These expressions, if they are separated with an equality, we call it as a equation. See this, x plus 3 is an expression. If it is equated with any other number, then it becomes a equation. Linear equation, when the variable power is 1, then we call it as a linear equation. And in that equation, if we use only one variable, we call it as a linear equation in one variable. And to solve any equation, we have two methods. One is balancing the equation and another is transposing the equation. First, try to learn solving equation by using balancing method. I think in class 7 you have done this. Now you can do directly by using transposing method. Suppose if they ask you to solve the problem by balancing method, you can go with that. Otherwise, directly you can move with transposing. Let's start the exercise. Exercise 3.1. First main, we have only one main, solve the following equations. In this main, you have 12 sub-questions. Let me start doing these problems. If you feel you can do these all problems, just pause the video. And after you complete your problems, you can play the video and compare your answers along with my answers. Okay, let us begin with the first problem. First one, x minus 2 equal to 7. As you know that any equation you can solve in two methods. Either you may go with the balancing method or transposing method. I feel transposing method is very easy for you. If you feel balancing is easy, you can go with that method. Right? First thing what you need to do, observe the variable. Other than variable, any number there, you need to check first. X minus 2 equal to 7. Variable is x. Other than variable, you can see here minus 2. Minus 2, transpose other side first. Solution, x minus 2 equal to 7. Again, take the question. Other than variable, what do you have? Minus 2. Minus 2, transpose other side. What happens? X is equal to 7. Minus 2, if it is transposed, it changes the sign. Plus 2. Minus 2, if it is transposed, it will be plus 2. Now add these two, 7 plus 2 will be 9. What is your x value? 9. That's it. Let's move to the second one. Observe the variable in this, y plus 3 equal to 10. What is the variable you can see here? Y. Y is the variable. Other than variable, what do you have? Plus 3. Plus 3 is send other side. That means transpose other side, y is equal to 10 plus 3 transpose means minus 3. 10 minus 3 will be 7. What is y value? 7. Third one, 6 is equal to z plus 2. Z plus 2, what is the variable here? Alphabet, z is the variable. So other than z, what do you have? Plus 2. Rewrite the question in solution. 6 is equal to z plus 2. Z is the variable. So other than variable, what do you have? Plus 2. Transpose other side. 6 minus 2. If you have plus here, if it goes other side, it will be minus. Okay? 6 minus 2 is 4 equal to z you can write, or z equal to 4 also you can write. When you are transposing at a time LHS, RHS, RHS to LHS, there is no change of sign. See here, when 4 is transposed to RHS and z is transposed to LHS, there is no change of sign. Okay? Here any one term is transposed, then it changes the sign. Okay? Fourth one. 3 by 7 plus x is equal to 17 by 7. Solution. 3 by 7 plus x equal to 17 by 7. Where is the variable? X is the variable. Rewrite the question. 3 by 7 plus x is equal to 17 by 7. Other than variable, 3 by 7, it is positive. When it is transposed other side, we are going to subtract that number. X is equal to 17 by 7 minus 3 by 7. Okay? Now do LCM. 7, 17 minus 3, it will be 14 by 7. 7 2s are 14. X is equal to 2. What is x? X value is 2. Fifth one, 6x is equal to 12. Here you can observe, for variable there is a numerical coefficient. A number is multiplied for variable. Multiple, if it is transposed other side, it will be divided. 6x is equal to 12. X is equal to multiple divided 12 by 6. That is, x is equal to 2 is your answer. Okay? Next, t by 5 is equal to 10. Observe the variable. T is the variable. See, a number is divided here. Okay? So, if it is divided, when it is transposed, what happens? Divided means it is multiplied other side. That is, t is equal to 5. Multiply this side. 10 into 5, t is equal to 5 tens are 50. Okay? Are these easy? So, let's move to the seventh one. 2x by 3 is equal to 18. Observe here, with variable, there is a multiple and a number is divided. So first, what we need to do? First, this 3 transpose other side. Rewrite the question. 2x by 3 is equal to 18. First, this 3 transpose other side. What happens? If it goes other side, it will be multiplied. 18 into 3. Then 2x is equal to 18 threes are 54. Okay. Now, again with variable, what you have? A number is multiplied. So transpose other side, divide 54 by 2. That will be 27. 2 2s are 4, 1 left, 14, 2 7s are 14. Therefore, x is equal to 27 is your answer. Eighth one, 1.6 is equal to y by 1.5. Observe the variable here. What is the variable? Y. 1.6 is equal to y by 1.5. Variable, a decimal is divided here. Divided, this decimal, if you want to transpose other side, multiply. Multiply, 1.6 into 1.5 is equal to y. Multiply this one, 1.6 into 1.5, decimal multiplication, 5, 6 are 30, 5 ones are 5, plus 3, 8. Okay? And with 1 if you multiply, 16, 0. 8 plus 6, it will be 14, 240. Now, decimal, right? From right side, here one point, here one decimal there. So, 1 plus 1 will be 2. From right side, after 2 digits, put a point. That will be 2.40 or 2.4 you can write. You can leave this 0. Right? What is y value? 2.4. Ninth one. 7x minus 9 equal to 16. 7x minus 9 equal to 16. Where is the variable? X. Right? First, you just go with the number which is subtracted. This number transpose other side. 7x is equal to 16 plus 9. 16 plus 9 will be 25. Okay? Then again, this 7 I don't want. Only variable I want. When I solve an equation, I need to find the value of the variable. So, this 7 multiple transpose other side, it will be divided 25 by 7. Therefore, your x value is 25 by 7. Now, let's move to 10th problem. 14y minus 8 equal to 13. 14y minus 8 equal to 13. What is a variable? Y. Y is a variable. Other than this set, what do you have? Minus 8. Minus 8 transpose other side. 14y is equal to 13 plus 8. Minus 8, if it is transposed other side, sign will be changed. Plus 8. 14y is equal to 13 plus 8. It will be 21. 14y is equal to 21. Let me do here. 14 multiple transpose other side. Y is equal to 21 by 14. 21 by 14 you can cancel with 7 table. 7 3 is a 21 and 7 2 is a 14. Your answer is y is equal to 3 by 2. Let's see the 11th one. 17 plus 6p is equal to 9. Observe the variable. P is the variable. Rewrite the question. Solution. 17 plus 6p is equal to 9. Other than this, what do you have extra? 17. Transpose this 17 other side. 6p is equal to 9 minus 17. Plus 17, if it is transposed other side, it will be minus 17. 6p is equal to 9 minus 17, it will be minus 8. Observe here, when a positive number and a negative number there, subtract the smaller number from greater number and take the sign of greater number. Therefore, it is minus 8. Is only variable there? No, there is a numerical coefficient here. So, transpose this number other side. Multiple, if it goes other side, it will be divided. Minus 8 by 6. This in 2 table, 2 4s are, 2 3s are. Therefore, P is equal to minus 4 by 3 is your answer. Okay. Next, last one in this exercise. 12th one, x by 3 plus 1 is equal to 7 by 15. Observe, where is variable? X is variable. So, other than this set, what do you have? Plus 1. Plus 1 transpose other side. X by 3 is equal to 7 by 15 minus 1. Do LCM. X by 3 is equal to 15 LCM. 7 minus 15. I think you all know how to do LCM. So, 15 table 1, sir. So, 1 multiplied here. And 1 table 1, 15, sir. So, 15 multiplied there. 7 minus 15, it will be minus 8, right? Minus 8 by 15. X by 3 is equal to minus 8 by 15. Now, this 3 transpose other side.
x is equal to minus 8 by 15 into 3.
You can cancel, right?
3 ones are, 3 fives are. Therefore, x is equal to minus 8 by 5.
Okay, x is equal to how much?
Minus 8 by 5.
With this, we are going to complete this exercise. Observe here, children, while you are doing problems, carefully you need to do. Solving any equation, we need to first observe the variable. Other than variable, whatever you have transposed to other side. Okay, left hand side, right hand side, you know. Suppose if any positive number is there, transpose other side, it will be subtracted. Right? If any negative number there, transpose other side, it will be added. Suppose if any multiple there, that number if we transpose, it will be divided. Any divisor there, if it is transposed, it will be multiplied on other side. Don't confuse, right? Do all these problems now itself one or two times and practice, right? With this, I'm going to end my session. In our next session, we are going to continue with the next exercise. Until then, keep watching. Thank you all.